What is going on YouTube? My name is Robert. In this video, I'll be sharing how to pitch an apartment complex owner for your Airbnb business with rental arbitrage in 2019. Yo, what's going on, guys? So recently, I was able to meet with an apartment complex owner of multiple apartment complexes in multiple different states. I think they own apartment complexes in like 12 different states. This is a huge investment group, and I was privileged enough to sit down with the president of this company and discuss rental arbitrage with him. So since I did this, guys, you guys don't have to go out there and do it. I'm gonna share bits and pieces from that meeting. I'm gonna let you guys in on what exactly was said, what his concerns were with what I proposed to him, and what you guys can be expecting when you approach apartment complex owners moving forward. So stay tuned for this video if you are curious on what exactly you are getting into when you meet with people like this. So guys, I'm just a 21-year-old Airbnb host here in Springfield, Missouri. It's a super small town. And if I can do this, so can you guys. That's literally what I'm trying to show you guys with this channel. All I'm trying to do is relay the message that all you have to do in order to succeed is take action. So guys, you guys already know about my single family home venture. You guys can go find all of my content that I've made regarding that and all the videos I've made in the past. What I decided to do was actually experiment a little bit with the apartment complex aspect of this business model. I know that with apartment complex units, this is a much easier model to scale. And the single family home method works, and I've been doing it successfully, but I want to get myself, you know, and spread out in different areas of rental arbitrage. I was able to sit down with a president of an investment group that owns a lot of apartment complexes. And what they do, they buy old buildings, they remodel them, they redo the entire infrastructure, and they turn them into beautiful luxury lofts and luxury units. And it took a little bit of digging, so as far as me setting up the meeting, you know, I did it my own way. And if you guys want to set up meetings with these kinds of elite people, you guys are going to have to get creative. But in order to successfully pitch them, you have to be able to sit down face to face. I don't recommend you do it over the phone. I don't recommend you try doing it any other way than sitting down at a conference table, sitting down in a meeting room with these people and giving them your idea. So then let's get right to the point. The first thing you're going to have to do is set up the meeting. This is by far, you know, it could be the most challenging thing you do. If you are presentable and if you know exactly what you're doing and you know what you're doing with confidence, then getting in front of them will probably be the hardest part, because when you're at the meeting, sitting down, discussing things, it won't be as complicated. What I really want to do today is share with you guys three questions that this apartment complex owner had for me regarding rental arbitrage. I brought my journal with me and I wrote them all down just so I could be prepared for whatever is to come, right? Like if he has objections, if he has reasons that he wouldn't let me, I want to know these reasons. And moving forward with different apartment complex owners, I could discuss these terms, maybe negotiate and figure out a common ground where we could get along. His first question to me was, how do I know you're going to hit your occupancy every single month? Because that's something I don't have control over. You're the guy managing the Airbnb unit. How do I know that you're going to be able to get the occupancy you need to cover my rent? Because I let him know that I'll be renting the unit from him as a regular tenant, but I'll be using it for Airbnb. And my answer to him was, my rent will be there as collateral. I told him that I will have my rent on the table every single month, and if I don't hit my numbers, then I'll still pay him his rent. That was a very easy and straightforward answer for me, and I think that's something you guys can definitely take and write that down somewhere, have that as value. Just know that you're gonna be paying your rent to him every single month, regardless if you hit your numbers and if you're in the profits, or if you don't hit them and you're losing money. And to him, revenue is revenue. That's one thing you guys have to understand about these apartment complex owners. They don't operate at 100% occupancy all the time. People leave for various different reasons, and there's vacancies in these units. And to somebody who owns a property as an investment property, they're gonna wanna have that thing completely filled. That's their goal, right? That's why they own that, so they can generate cash flow. And that's what he told me. He said, revenue is revenue, and I really like what you're telling me here. That was a really great way to establish, you know, the first part of that meeting, to where we could extend it a little bit longer and I could discuss more things with him. His second question to me was, how do I know that the people who book the Airbnb are going to like the place? And this was kind of something that was geared more towards like the pessimistic aspect of it. I told him to give me all of his concerns and express all of his concerns. And obviously, as an apartment complex owner, he wants to keep up his image and keep that place with positive reviews online in general. His concern was, how do I know that the Airbnb guests that are your Airbnb guests are going to like my apartment? That's something that's really not in anyone's control. I told him that I would do everything I could to ensure that I get 5-star reviews, because that benefits me and my business. I'm striving for super host status. I'm striving to rank higher on Airbnb's website. Therefore, my intentions with this listing are to have 5-star reviews no matter what. And I told him I would do my part, and he said he understands that I would do my part, but what if they don't like the apartment complex itself? And that in itself is something that is out of his control, I think. You know, people are hard to please. I let him know that, you know, when you're trying to, you know, please people, there's always gonna be somebody who has something to complain about. That's something that I've learned as a host. People are very hard to please. And I, you know, that's something that he had as a question or as a concern, and I respect that, and there's nothing I can do about it. I told him, like I said before, that I would make sure that I would do everything on my end to ensure that I get 5-star reviews. The last question he had for me was a more strategic business question. He asked me, who's gonna pay the occupancy tax for Airbnb, and how do I know that you're gonna pay your tax? Like, what if you don't pay your occupancy taxes and then the city comes after my apartment complex because that's the unit that the Airbnb is operating out of? So his main concern was he doesn't want to be in trouble with the city just because I, for some reason, I'm not paying my taxes. This information is highly valuable for anybody trying to approach apartment complex owners about rental arbitrage. I think that the more you approach these people, the more that you will figure out what, you know, what is their main concern. So for the most part, guys, that question about the occupancy tax, I know that the state of Missouri collects the occupancy tax on the state level. On the local level, there's obviously regulations if you live in an area that has regulations. So the city of Springfield so far has passed the fact that they're going to be collecting the occupancy tax and the hotel tax from Airbnb hosts, but they're not enforcing it yet. There's like a 6-month grace period for hosts that need to figure this out. So for the most part, I told them, you know, like, I'm in this phase where I'm figuring it out on my own with my single family Airbnb property, and I'll definitely be on top of it. So guys, if you can answer these questions for an apartment complex owner whenever you're at the meeting, you know, that'll really increase the chances of them saying yes. So the current status on the meeting that I had, the owner said he's gonna look at his leasing agreement with the leasing agency that he has, and he's gonna see if there's any conflict. So I'm at a point where I'm gonna follow up with him and I'll figure out more information in the next month or so. So that is my situation. I'm super excited, and I'm glad that I stepped out of my comfort zone to meet with this man. Guys, the whole point is here that all you have to do is take that leap and take action. If you never do that, you'll never figure anything out. So for every one of you guys out there who is considering, you know, pitching a landlord, pitching an apartment complex owner for rental arbitrage, the best advice I can give you is to go do it. Stop watching this video, stop listening to me, find out who owns these properties and sit there face to face with them and let them know and present your business idea. Because ultimately, guys, this business idea is a rock solid one, and that is something that he told me himself. He told me he loves this idea, he loves what I'm sharing with him, and, you know, to him, revenue is revenue. That's something that really reinforced everything that was said in that meeting. He likes the fact that I'm putting myself out there and I'm offering him to fill his apartment complex for 100% occupancy for the next 5 years, for the next 10 years, however long it may be. What you really have to consider here is the fact that you are going to be offering them rent. For an apartment complex owner, like I said before, they're not gonna be operating at 100% occupancy all the time. And therefore, when you offer them that cash, you're offering to fill up that hole in their revenue, right? They're gonna like that a lot. So take that, guys, and apply it. The more you do this with multiple different owners, the more you'll find that once you have one business model working for you, it is easy to refer back to that working social model, and you can use that as your social proof and show them that this is my cash flow here, this is working for me here, I can make the same thing work for you. There you guys have it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and this is probably one of the most value-packed videos I've ever made. Once again, guys, I'm waiting to hear back from this apartment complex owner. He's looking into his lease agreement with the leasing company that he has hired, because he doesn't do that himself. He has like a leasing agency or leasing company that does all that for him. So he's looking through the contracts. He's gonna make sure that everything's okay. I went in that with this apartment complex owner so you guys don't have to. At least you guys have a little bit of insight on what to expect moving forward. Once you guys schedule that meeting, you'll be able to refer back to these three questions that this man had. Like I said before, this guy owns multiple apartment complexes. This would be a very great relationship to establish and to grow. If I can get in with his, you know, with the first unit and I show him that it works, he'll be willing to give me the rest of his units, you know, 100%, because like I said before, they're not always 100% occupied, and you can definitely build value in some way, shape, or form. If you guys haven't yet, be sure to go check out my Facebook group. It's growing at a rapid rate. There's tons of hosts in there who always answer questions if I can't answer them for you. It's a very great community to be a part of. Any one of you guys who has questions, just be sure to join that Facebook group. And if you're looking for more specific information, like how to pitch the landlord with a written script, I know a lot of you guys watching these videos want to learn how to start, or maybe you guys already have one listing, you guys already have two listings, and you just want to scale it, I definitely recommend checking out my course. It's called Airbnb Mastery Through Rental Arbitrage, and it's linked down below. You guys can go find this information, and I put a lot of value into this course. One thing I did do is spend a lot of time making sure that what I provide is valuable. And I'm adding a bunch of information to the course, and this is something that's gonna be forever updated based off of how I'm doing in my current ventures. So like I said, I just currently have been doing single family home rental arbitrage, but now I'm getting into the apartment complex aspect of it. And all of that information that I'm acquiring is going into the course. And that's something you guys will have forever as an updated source of information on whatever you guys want to do. If you are a member of my course, I will make myself available to you to answer questions and help you, even to the point where like I can schedule a phone call, a 15-minute phone call a day, and get you through the process. My only goal with this product and with this course is to see results in my students. I just think that it'd be a very effective way of helping more people. So the fact that I can put this information in one place, have it all compiled, have it updated, have it relevant, and then have you guys go through that information, right? Because all the questions that you guys ask me, all the questions I get all the time, a lot of that information is in the course. And therefore, I think you guys would find that very valuable. After you guys have taken it, you know, if you have more in-depth questions, I'm here for you guys. I'll have a more personal contact with you after that point. So guys, once again, thank you all for staying tuned. And I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. Be sure to smash like and subscribe, and I will see you all in the next one.